And we are ready for high school basketball tonight on Cool 101.7. Chuck Stopp, along with Gary Patten, and we welcome Armstrong to our broadcast tonight down here as we look for a good one tonight, Gary.
Absolutely. I tell you what, always a thrill to come down here. Great facility to broadcast, great people, good atmosphere. Looking forward to a great game tonight right here at Cochranton High School.
And Jeff Corey tonight will be on the camera. Here we go. Cardinals shooting to the left. Panthers to the right in half number one. Greenlee will on the jump. He'll jump against Dallin McGee, and the ball is out of bounds. And the ball is going to be the Panthers. So Cardinals will drop right out in a man to start things out. McGill gets the ball into Pritchard. Over on the left wing to Rhodes. Rhodes back out to the top of the key to McGill. McGill looks inside. Nothing is there. He'll bring the ball over on the left wing, Bradley. And he threw the ball away. Up the court come the Cardinals in a hurry. Baker. The Wigan. In underneath. Greeny lays it up and in, and the Cardinals are on the board.
That's the way to cash in on the turnover. Two zip cards. Well, we watched the Panthers struggle getting the ball underneath against Springs.
That they did because of that big Springs ball coming. Kick the ball down to the right wing. Open for the three is Pritchard, and he nailed it.
First point of the night, Panthers hit it. They're up 3-2.
So Cardinals bring the ball up the court. Bernarding gets the ball down on the left wing to Baker. Back out. Wigan gets the ball to Bernarding. Bernarding sideline right. Steps back, takes a three, off target, no good. Rebounded by Phelan of the Panthers. Long pass up into the forecourt to Bradley. Now in underneath, McGill's got it, bites it up and in.
Wow, right around two of the Card defenders. 5-2, Saegertown.
Bernarding to Wigden. He'll go in, take a bank shot. That shot is no good as he tried to put over Phelan. On the floor, jump ball. Possession will go to Saegertown. Cochranton. No, that's Saegertown. Out of bounds to throw that ball in will be Dana Rhodes, 6 foot senior.
Coach Greg discussing what just happened previously. Not sure if he wanted. Nothing was called.
Well, let's see what they're going to call here now. Two officials get together. Sooner or later, they'll get it all ironed out.
And game. They did.
And the ball will be the Cardinals' inbound. Frymouth inbound. Baseline left. Looking, 5 seconds. Left corner, Bernarding to Baker. Baker, double team, back out top of the key, driving in, the bank shot's on the rim and in by Wigman.
Nice move underneath, 5-4. Cards down by one.
The Panthers move on the attack from left to right. Into McGill. McGill, double team, down into the right corner for the three. Pritchard, that's no good, rebound Cards. Bernarding races the ball to the top of the key. Over to Wigden, penetrates, back out front to Braden. Braden over to Wigden. Wigden wanted to penetrate,
lost the ball.
That ball is going to be picked up by Pritchard. Pritchard reaching behind as Wigden knocks the ball away. Up the court, ball belongs to Saegertown. Ball will be out of bounds in front of the Cardinal bench.
Saegertown with the 5-4 lead. They've got the ball, 5:50 and running first period.
Phelan inbounds. Phelan, right wing, to Bradley. Bradley, double team, down to the baseline, open jumper by Phelan, that's no good. They get the missed shot, McGill on the weak side, but he threw the ball away. Bernarding got it. Bernarding to the front court, to the high post. Just the ball to the baseline.
Wide
Bradley
open.
Goes in and goes up and gets fouled.
First penalty tonight. goes against Saegertown.
We'll send Greenlee to the free throw line for the Cards.
See if he can hit this one and tie the game.
Short. Five, four, Panthers. Greenlee for one more. Line left. Strong again. Hauled down by Braden. Bernarding. Dwigden's got it in the paint, but that's sealed off. Back out. 12-foot jumper. That is no good. Braden rebounded. Put it back up and in. And that is goodbye for Farmers. Curtis Farmers.
Cochranton back up 6-5.
Into the front court. It's Pritchard. Bounce the ball down into the corner to McGill. McGill sideline low. McGill against Greenlee. Back out top of the key once again to Pritchard. Holds. Feeds the ball out to Bradley. Bradley really being harassed by Brayton. Comes back out to the top of the key. Thielen. Thielen's going to drive in. Screeches ball drives to force one. Blocked away and taken away by Farmer. Up the court to Greenlee. He'll drive and put it up. No good. Ball is loose. Picked up. And then a foul is called as finally Pritchard picked the ball up. And the foul is called.
Cochranton with their first foul. .427 remaining here in the first period. 6-5, Cochranton by one. Saegertown with the ball. Here we go.
Bounce to McGill. McGill topside. Tried to get the ball in underneath. And that ball is batted out of bounds and lost over there by Bradley. Cochranton will get it back. Farmworth to inbound. To Wigden. Wigden to the forecourt. Bounce the ball out to the top of the key. Baker's got it. Free throw line into the paint. The ball back out front. Throw the ball to Farmer. Almost lost it. That time was the Cardinals, Curtis Farmer. To Bernarding, steps into the circle, left wing.
Wide open.
Three buried over here by Wigden.
Boy, they left him wide open. Easy shot, he hit it. 9-5, Cochranton.
McGill, top of the key. Cardinals stay on the man. Back out, top of the key. McGill, seal feed over to Pritchard. Wide open again, corner right, shots no good, feeling out of bounds. Foul call. Farmworth will step out of bounds to throw it in for Cochranton.
Bradley with a foul, his first, team second. Cochranton will get the ball.
Curtis. Oh. Now Greenlee will step out of bounds to throw it in.
Cochranton with a 4-point lead, 3:28 remaining here in the first.
And a whistle. And now we're ready for action. Wigden. The Yoders now just checked in their senior, 5'10". Right corner shot will not fall. Wigden rebound weak side, Saegertown. McGill up the court. McGill to the top of the key. McGill to the high post. Double team. Ball's knocked loose. It is loose. Trying to save it from going out of bounds. Is Wigden good hustle by him? Couldn't do it. Saegertown's ball. The left of the circle. Rhodes had it. Back off. Right wing putting up a three. Partially blocked. I think Zach Wigden got a little bit on that ball. And the rebound comes down to Greenlee. Over to Cole Bernarding. Bernarding out front. And it's thrown away.
Yep, there's a turnover. Cochranton second.
Garrett Yoder just tossed that thing out of bounds.
Panthers get the ball back, down by four, 2:40 on the clock.
Inbound to Seiple, Steve Seiple. He'll bring the ball into the forecourt, dish the ball down to the right corner. Another Panther is wide open, shot will not go down. by Bradley. Rebounded Cochranton, giving him just one shot to Baker. Baker double team, puts it high to the glass.
Very
won't
short.
Go. Rebound is Cochranton's. You know, driving the layup, that is no good, and a foul called as Yoder was taking it in.
Might have called it on Rhodes. Saegertown's third foul. McGill with the foul. Allen and McGill, it'd be his first.
Free throw is up around the rim and drops off. Cochranton is a 61% foul shooting team.
I think they've hit one yet tonight.
Bernarding back in for the Cards. Tyler Framworth checks in for the Cards. Yoder for one more. Good.
10-5 as he hits that one and splits the pair.
Well, it's been a 6-point run now by the Cardinals. McGill. Beal out front. To Seiple. Down into the right corner, open. Thielen, another three. That bounds off the iron, no good. Rebounded on the weak side. Panthers, McGill for three, left wing. That's no good. High in the air. And hauled down by Cochran and Bernard and brings the ball up the court. It's knocked away from him. Good defense over there by the Panthers. As Sherry reached in, slapped that ball away. And ends up getting away from him and out of bounds. The Cardinals will throw the ball in. Inbounding will be Baker. Dump the ball
good,
down
great
low,
there,
tipped
defense.
Away. Yep, that's McGill. It's loose
right
again.
Back
Cardinals
at him.
Get it. Greenlee, it passes. It's stolen away. Stolen away by Seiple.
And again, another turnover. Wow.
Racking them up here in the first quarter. 1:37 to go. First quarter, 10-7, Cochranton.
Four right there in that transaction. 1:37 on the clock.
Now more subs coming in for the Cardinals. Chase Hoffman, 6'4 senior, is in.
And another one comes in for Saegertown.
Going out is Rhodes.
Back to action. Cards with the ball up by five. 10-5 your score.
In for Kyle Schlosser's in for Saegertown. Out to the top of the key. Bernarding, three, won't go. Left wing. Rebounded. And a foul is called. Ball will be taken out of bounds. Ball is called against the Cardinals. Curtis Framworth. McGill inbound. Allen triggers that ball right into Pritchard. Pritchard in the backcourt against Bernarding. Gets the ball to Seiple. Seiple goes up with the right hand, puts it to the glass. That's no good.
Got the rebound.
By McGill. He's double teamed. He lost the ball. Picks it back up, and they end up calling a jump ball. Possession will belong to the Panthers. Out of bounds to throw it in. It will be Claire Pritchard. No. Stepping out of bounds to throw it in will be
Sherry. Grant. Ryan Sherry threw it in.
Round the horn. Over here to Seiple. Three-point arc right side. Back to the point to McGill. He goes left of the circle. Passes the ball up, and the ball is away and out of bounds off Ryan Sherry.
Another turnover. Six turnovers for the Panthers. We're under a minute. Still 10-5 Cochranton.
Bernarding will be guarded by Sherry. Changes in on the dribble, down to the corner. Now back on the give and go, Baker up good and fouled.
Right, muscled his way in there, got the layup, 12-5.
Five players have scored in the opening period for the Cards. Saegertown has a three out of Pritchard and a deuce out of McGill to put them up 5-4, but they haven't scored since. Cardinals looking for their ninth straight, and there it is.
13-5 Cards. Panthers
full
struggling to get it in.
5 seconds.
And another turnover. Yep, that took way too long.
Out of bounds to throw it in, Curtis Framworth. to the left of there, bucket into Bernarding. Bernarding corner left. Out front to Zach Wigan. Back to Bernarding, sticks inside the arc on the left wing. Down to Baker, drives the right baseline. Foul called on Ellen. That is now the fourth foul. Now make it the fifth foul as they finally posted it.
His third already.
Austin Brown checks in for Saegertown. Austin, a senior, 6'2".
Then you got to take McGill out. He's got three fouls already in the first period.
Farmer inbound, gets the ball knocked away from Baker. Up the court comes Sherry. He lost it away, stolen by Baker. He's double-teamed. The ball ends up out of bounds. Ball is going to be Cochranton. With 29 seconds remaining in the first period here on Cool and Armstrong tonight. 13-5. It is in favor of Cochranton. Saegertown hasn't scored in the last 5 minutes. Bernarding. Braden. Bernarding's got it over the head pass to Baker.
Winding down.
To Wigan, 10 seconds to go. Zach onto the dribble. Had the ball knocked away and out of bounds by Seipel. Farmerth inbound. Looking into Braden. Braden to Farmerth. To Yoder. Way out, a long ball, and that's no good at the buzzer by Curtis Farmer. That's the end of the first quarter. In Cochranton, tonight the score, Cochranton 13, Saegertown 5 at the end of one here on Cool and Armstrong. Chuck Stopp, Gary Patten. That's Region 3 high school basketball tonight on Cool 101.7. We're at the end of one quarter. Cochranton leads 13-5. They have scored the last 9 points. They were down 5-4. Cochranton with the ball. Wigan, left wing, dishes the ball in there, underneath, drive to the rack, lay it up, that's no good. Hoffman, and on the rebound, hauled down by Hoffman, and then a foul called. No foul called, Saegertown's ball. Here comes the Panthers back up in the backcourt. Bradley, off to Sherry. Sherry dishes the ball down low, fall away, short jumper is up, no good. Bradley, baseline right, rebound in underneath, a near tie up, and they'll finally call the tie. Ball belongs to Cochranton. Panthers a fall back, pick him up in midcourt. Here comes Zach Wigman. To Braden. Ball is lost out of bounds here. Who last touched it? Saegertown. Curtis out of bounds to throw it in. Looks, looks. Braden, wide open three, left wing, no good. Rebound is loose and the Panthers got it. Falling it away that time was Rhodes.
Yeah, they're doing a good
and
job on the boards.
High up nearly, but Panthers come away with it. Pritchard back out front, and they'll set it up over to Bradley. Bradley against Braden is in. Brings the ball back out front. Dumped the ball in, tried to get it on the give and go on the paint, but the ball is kicked.
That's the way the Panthers are struggling, trying to work that ball underneath, Chuck.
Not having much luck tonight.
No, not at all.
Under 7 minutes to go, first half.
Still 13-5. Cochranton. Panthers have gone cold.
They certainly haven't probably scored about the last 6 minutes. Sherry kicked the ball out. He had a wide open shot from probably about 14 feet. Wouldn't take it.
Should have took it.
Now they got the ball in underneath, but that's...
And they turn it over.
Off and, yep. Here comes Bernarding. Bernarding up ahead to Hoffman. He saved it from going out of bounds, but right into the Panthers. Down below us, Bradley has it. Over to Seipel. Seipel to the forecourt. Hawkinson staying in there, man. Down to Bradley. kick the ball to the left wing, back out to the top of the key, around the horn, hurry to Seiple. Ball was almost thrown away. Seiple saved it for him.
Whoa.
Seiple to Phelan. Phelan brings the ball from right to left. And the Bradley, open, three left wing, rolls it over the rim, no good. Cochranton's Bernarding races the ball to the forecourt, to the top of the key, goes in from the left
nice
side, tried
feet.
To pass
oh.
the ball off to Baker, but it's out of bounds.
Had a nice feed, one of the Panthers got in there, got their hand on it.
In for Cochranton, Garrett Yoder again. Frymarth out. Baker out of bounds to throw it in.
Sherry goes out for Saegertown.
Greenlee back in for Cochranton. Got a little height there. Over to Zach. The high post. Back out front. Open Yoder. Three. Yes, on the right wing.
Finally, Cochranton hits a bucket. 16-5.
12 in a row for the Cardinals. Down to the left baseline, short jumper and up, and that is no good. Rhodes rebound,
Cochranton
fast
break.
Nope, foul will be called.
Bernarding driving, got fouled. Let's see who they call it on.
Foul is going to be called on Nick Bradley.
His second, team sixth.
Bernarding looks for his first point of the night, averaging close to 13 points a ball game, 65%. Foul shooter, he sinks the first one.
17-5, Cochranton. 5:22 remaining here in the first half. Second
left
shot is up.
Is up and on the rim.
Make it 18-5. Cardinals, timeout has been taken.
We'll take a timeout on cool. 5:22 to go in the first half. Cardinals on a roll. They've now scored the last 14 in a row. We'll be back. They're up by 13. Right back here in Cochranton. Big gear. Nice crowd in here tonight.
Absolutely.
Cardinals have scored 14 in a row after the Panthers are up 5-4.
Well, they can't get it underneath.
All the way.
Yeah, another turnover.
Richard, he turns it all over. Up the court comes Garrett Yoder. Bounce pass, dangerous pass, but they get the ball down low. Greenlee's got it, goes
right
in and a foul will be called.
Thought he had a good block, but drew the foul.
Could be Dana Rhodes on the foul, and it is. He picked up the foul.
Yep, that's number seven for Saegertown.
No, actually called on Seiple.
Maybe Seiple's first shot is up.
Perfect.
19-5 as he sinks that one.
Finally now, one of two from the free throw line, line left. This charity toss is up and strong. Rebound, Cardinals get it. Really, bank shot is no good from short range. Panthers got it. Trying to score here, they haven't scored in about the last 7 minutes. Shot, Seiple off, balance up, no good. Rebound, Cardinals. Yoder's got it, cross court, Bernarding. Wide open corner left, no good, off the iron, weak side. On the rebound, foul called against Cochranton's Braden Baker.
As he hit the hardwood there, sliding. His first foul, team's third. Panthers will get the ball back down 19-5.
Clock's still running away.
Clock's running away. Well,
you know, they finally shut it down after about 10 seconds ran off. What that was all about. Inbound.
Body's flying every which way,
now,
steal.
Putting it up. Yoder, and he gets fouled. At the charity line for the Cardinals will be Yoder.
That brought Coach Greg right off the bench.
Yoder four in the ball game. One of two from the free throw line tonight. Good.
20-5.
Free throw in and out and back in again. 17 points in a row for the Redbirds.
21-5, Cochranton.
Oh, there's almost a carry there.
Boy, are they struggling.
McGill against Greenlee, and I'm going to call a push off against Greenlee. He doesn't like it.
And it's only the fourth foul. 4:36 remaining here in the first half.
Feeling the inbound to Miguel. Miguel greenly guarding him. Back out front to Pritchard. Pritchard hands the ball off. Going in, pass the ball, Miguel. Miguel goes into the lane, puts it up. It's strong again. Rebounded by Greenlee, but he lost the ball away. Picked up by Phelan. To Pritchard, across the paint. Seipel, corner left. 4:10 to go first down. Tried to get that ball in there to Miguel. Slapped away by Greenlee, but it's picked up by Seipel in the left corner. Back out front to Bradley. Bradley, left-handed dribble. Corner to Seipel. Back to Miguel. Take the shot over Greenlee. Throws up an air ball. And it is out of bounds as Cole Bernarding just let it go. Cardinals get the ball back.
Saegertown continue to struggle.
Well,
wow.
4 minutes gone on this one. They didn't score in at least maybe the 4 or 5 minutes of the last quarter after they took a 5-4 lead, Big Gear.
I tell you what, it has definitely gone cold. They're trying, but
coming up empty.
Can't get underneath, can't work the ball underneath, can't hit the threes.
Owen Chess is now in for Saegertown. He is a 6'1 junior. Rigdon in the front court to the top of the key. Feeds to Garrett Yoder. In the lane, passes the ball off. Wide open, another three. Bingo by the Cardinals. That is knocked down by Hoffman.
4-5.
His first three up the court. Another foul is going to be called against Zach Wigdon. Cardinals have now scored 20 unanswered points.
That'll be the team's fifth foul, his first. Another player checking in.
That'll be Tyler Frank for the first time tonight. Bernarding back in. Out goes Baker. Out goes Zach Wigdon. We're going to see the whole roster for Cochranton tonight.
Yeah, we're only in the second period.
Feeling all inbound baseline right. This is right in for
there
the short
we go.
Jumper with the left hand. It is good by Chess.
Had to break the ice.
Hoffman, corner right. Out front to Yoder.
Saved it.
And over and back, and now now they're going to call a push off.
Coach Greg wanted a different call.
He wanted over and back, but he said no, it'd been tipped back. So the ball belongs to the Redbirds.
Up right now, 24-7.
On a 20-2 run. Now, that was a problem with Saegertown against Cambridge Springs, coming with just 1 point. Around the horn they move. Bernarding, left-handed dribble, dumps the ball off. Back, open, Hoffman, three, strong off of the glass. Rebound taken away by Seipel. Under 3 minutes to go in the first half, 24-7. Seipel, blocking foul call.
Block called.
Now they'll go against.
Wow, the fans wanted a charge.
That is Curtis.
His second foul, team sixth. Panthers get the ball back. 2:54 remaining here in the first half. Now we have, here we go.
Zach Wigdon in. Out for Cochranton will be Yoder. Phelan will inbound.
Better get it in.
Right of their hoop. And the ball is lost away. Picked up by Wigdon. He lost it away, but a foul will be called. Foul on Seipel. No, I'm sorry, Chess. Subs coming in now for the Cardinals here. Free throw line. Wigdon connects on the first one.
25-7. 2:51 remaining here in the first half. Second shot coming up.
Drazina in for Cochranton. Second charity toss to the rim and got the roll.
make it 26-7 Cochranton.
7 points tonight for Zach. Chess to McGill. McGill left side, turns all the way around. Needs some help. Takes a dribble. Back out front. Over to Chess. Chess high post left. Guarded out there by Wigan. To McGill. Down into the corner, Phelan, right side. 2:24 to go here in this first half. Cochranton dominating quarter number two. Here's
nice
one off of the
turner.
Glass. Once again, knocked down by Seipel.
26-9 as he hits that bucket.
Will be his first point of the night.
He's just got to get warmed up.
Drazina over to Baker. Baker high post, backing his way in. Double team traveled. Full court pressure by the Cards. 5 seconds. Long inbound pass comes into Chess at midcourt. He is double teamed. He's in trouble. Pass the ball to McGill. Back out top of the key. Seipel three to the rim and did not get the roll. Rebounded by the Cardinals. And up the court they move in a hurry. Bernarding to the front court. Long pass over to Wigan. He'll penetrate.
Well,
and he traveled.
Another turnover, number 10.
Foot slipped there and called for the traveling violation. 26-9 at Cochranton.
So the Panthers get the ball back. Minute 42 remaining here in the first. Down 26-9, as Chuck said.
Bradley back in for the Cards. Going out Chess. Long inbound pass from Phelan to Seipel. Now down to the left corner for the
there
first slasher.
There you go. 26-12 as they hit that three.
His first points of the night. Here come the Redbirds.
Two more, then they'll be back in the game.
Top of the key. Dish the ball down along. Turning around, putting up the short jumper. That is no good. Hoffman rebounded by Saegertown. Coming up on the 1 minute mark. Seipel charged.
There's the charge this time. With the ball right back to the Cards. Minute 10 remaining here. First half, 26-12, Cochranton.
Waiting to get some of the moisture off the court and some of the sweat down there after bodies were flying all over the court there after the charge.
Don't forget you can catch this game once again on Armstrong. Playback will be Wednesday, 8 o'clock, and again on Thursday at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Armstrong Cable.
Here comes Zach Wigan. Panthers in the man. Bernarding, the pick and roll. Bernarding, free throw line, shot is on the rim and in.
Make it 28-12.
Long pass into the front court to break that zone press, and they do it. Out front, Phelan behind the back. It was stolen by Bernardi. He picked his pocket. He'll drive and score.
That's the way you cash in on a turnover.
Six by Cole, all in this period. And the Cardinals lead by the big 18.
Pouring it on.
Seipel into the front court. He'll go in and just throw it up off balance. That's no good.
But he drew the foul.
He'll be at the charity line.
Cochranton's seventh foul. Two shots coming up. 27 seconds remaining here in the first half.
Seipel line, all right. Free throw, it is Miller. Chess is back in for Saegertown. Also back in for the Cats is Pritchard. Free throw, it is no good. It's loose. Wiggins got it up to Bernarding. Bernarding back to Wiggins. Three right side, no good. On the weak side, controlled by the Cardinals. Here goes Wiggins. Dumped the ball
nice
down
feet.
Low and a foul called. As the ball was gotten down there by Rosina, he drew the foul. free throw. He knocked it in.
31-12. Second shot coming up. 14 seconds remain here in the first half.
Gets the second. He has 2 points. 10 seconds to go in this first half. Out to the top of the key, nearly turned it over. Rhodes has got it. Dump pass down low, and it's nice save.
Whoa.
By Seipel, and swept out of bounds by Gazina. That is the end of the first half. And the Cochran Cardinals, who trailed 5-4, they put it up to a 32-12 lead at intermission. I want to remind you, you're listening to WMVL Lanesville, Meadville. We'll take this 2-minute timeout and be right back to Cochranton in this Region 3 encounter on Cool 101.7 and Armstrong.
Well, here come the Panthers back out here as we get ready to start the second half down right now, 32-12. They were down before the Springs, but we watched them come out in the second half and hit 9 threes, and they were down on their home court against the Blue Devils.
It'll be Rhodes, Thielen, Bradley, also Pritchard, Rhodes for Saegertown. For Cochranton, they'll come out with Baker, Wigdon, along with Farmerth, Curtis, Barnarding, and finally Chase Hoffman. Panthers with the ball. Cardinals pick them up at midcourt. Panthers shoot to the left, half number two here on Cool and Armstrong. Tried to force the ball down low. It was lost, picked back up, threw it up over his head. Then a foul is called as Thielen went down there and tried to flip it up, but it wouldn't fall, but he
drew the foul. Great move underneath, though.
Thielen of the free throw line tonight sinks the first one. That's their second free throw toss tonight. They're now one for one. He is a 63% foul shooter. Saegertown only 53% from the free throw line, but he sinks both of those.
32-14.
Here comes Bernardi to Baker. Bounce the ball. Top of the key. Hoffman for three. Yes! That's his second triple tonight. Cardinals 35-14. McGill underneath, wide open.
Lay it up, wow.
And missed the bunny. In underneath was Rhodes.
Should have been an easy two.
Bernarding to the front court right wing. Round the horn it goes to Farmer. Hoffman. Back to Wigdon. He's called for the charge down the right baseline. Just underway in the second half. Calling for a little elbowing there. Full court pressure by Cochran. They've showed that all night long. Straight up man-to-man. Here comes McGill. McGill into the forecourt. The left-hand dribble goes to the right. Cuts inside of the circle. Backs off again. Gets the ball over. Now in underneath, McGill's got it. And puts it up and in.
Boy, nice move underneath. 35-16.
McGill, a couple field goals in the ball game in four. Straight out. 14-footer is no good by Hoffman. Rebound, Saegertown. Here comes Thielen. He just threw the ball away. Stolen the line. Up the court. Wigan had it, lost it, able to get the ball off to Baker. Back off, wide open. Another three. Hoffman buried another one. Timeout is called by Saegertown. 60-second timeout from Redbird Land with a score on Colin Armstrong. Cochranton 38, Saegertown 16. We're ready to go as the Cochranton Cardinals have come out in a 6-4 run to start the third quarter. Pushed themselves out to a 22-point lead. Pritchard, DeRhodes, back out front. Thielen has it. Looks left, dribbles to the right. Over to Bradley. Bradley underneath, reverse layup, no good. But rebounded, should be an easy one, but it won't fall that time by the court. Bradley of Saegertown, but drawing the foul was Rhodes. 38-16. Rhodes to the free throw line. Charity toss. High rainbow, no good. He only shoots 40% from the free throw line. Saegertown averages just under 42 points a ball game. Cochranton at 55. Defensively, Panthers giving up just over 57. Cochranton at 52. Short. Rebound. Oh, nice steal over there by Bradley. Down to the baseline. Back out front, McGillney lost it, but luckily for them, right over there is Bradley to pick it up. Bradley against Hoffman, goes to the baseline, down into the corner, wide open three, high rainbow shot, no good by Pritchard, rebounded by Cochranton. Frymuth up the court to Bernarding. Bernarding, and the whistle.
Double dribble. Turn the ball over to Saegertown.
I guess you can afford to do that when you're up by 52. McGill. Into Pritchard. Pritchard. Corner right, Phelan. Out to Rhodes. Rhodes right baseline. Double team. The ball is tipped away. Bernarding comes right down into the hands of Pritchard. Back to Rhodes.
Oh,
out front, through the ball into the back court and over and back.
We have a timeout taken by Coach Greg and the Saegertown Panthers. It'll be a full timeout.
We'll be right back after this timeout. 38-16, Cochranton. Cochranton will inbound at midcourt. Frymuth will do that. Curtis dumps it into Bernarding. Bernarding up the middle of the court. Baker has the ball left wing. Baker penetrates. Dumps the ball right side. Bernarding three. Right wing is short. The battle is on. Who got the ball? Brought away by Saegertown. McGill. Phelan corner right. Back out front. Bumps the ball into the paint. Stolen away. Here comes the Cardinals. Yoder. Hands the ball off. Put it up. Hoffman. No good foul.
Travel.
Charge.
No, it was a travel. They turn the ball right back over to Saegertown.
Out of bounds, McGill will trigger it in. Cardinals will drop off, pick him up at midcourt. Brady guarding Bradley. Get the ball into Allen. He'll put it up and in. Allen McGill has his 6 point of the game.
There's a good pass underneath.
Cardinals have gone a little dry spell now.
They can afford to.
Baker dumps the ball into Greenland. Chip set ball off out front. Top of the key. Drive into the lane. Back out front. Open another three. Knocked down by Drazina.
41-18, Cochranton. Halfway through the third period.
Seipel. Seipel. Corner right. Push off. Always on Bernarding.
His first, team's fourth already.
And Bernarding is out. Down to the right corner. Allen takes the three. McGee, that's no good. Sky to pull it down is Baker. Over to Wigan, who checked in for Bernarding. Thinking about another three, but driving in. A little finger roll, that's up. That is no good. Drazina. Rebound, tipped away. Cardinals got it again. Here goes Wigan, stopping pot off with glass and good.
43-18.
Pritchard. Bradley out front. Bradley. Bounces the ball, try to get on, give it go to Rhodes. Lost it. Back out front, open. Shot is up, and that's no good. Bradley and underneath, out of bounds. Saegertown's ball. Thielen inbound to the right of the cat hoop. In underneath, a short jumper is up to the glass and won't go down by Bradley, but another foul call.
That'll be the fifth one.
Foul is on Drazina.
His first.
Bradley to the free throw line, 56% foul shooter. No good.
Bernardine back in.
Baker goes out. 3:08 to go, third quarter. Free throw, no good. But what do we have, a lane violation? Yep, lane violation against Cochranton. See if he can redeem himself. He does. 43-19. Bernardi. Top of the key. Zach Wigan, high post, right, shoots. No good. Rebound comes down to Seipel. He's to the forecourt. Goal to win. Let up. Oh. It's no good. Bernardi with the rebound. 3-on-3 break. Bernardi, free throw line. Peels to the left wing. Top of the key, Wigan. Wigan down to the baseline, Drazina. Back out around the top of the key. Dump the ball down low to Greenlee. Ball went beyond and picks it up before it went out of bounds. Back to Bernarding. He's going to penetrate. Just threw it up the glass. No good travel.
And turn the ball over. 2:34 remaining here in the third. 43-19. Cochranton. Saegertown with the ball.
Cole Slusher comes in. Bradley goes out for Saegertown.
Boys high school basketball action right here on Cool 101.7 FM.
Out goes Drazina. In for Cochranton is Yoder Garrett. Left corner, Seipel. Down to the baseline. Seipel take a three on the right side. That's no good. Foul will be called. Seipel ended up on the seat of his pants. Foul called on Garrett Yoder.
Be the team sixth. His first.
Steve Seipel to the free throw line, 60% foul shooter. Missed one tonight from the stripe. This one is up and short.
Boy, they can't buy a bucket.
Second free throw. Good.
There.
You'll get another one. Fouled on the actor. A three shot. McGill is out.
Sam Michaels is in, number 33 for Saegertown.
Free throw, no good. Rebound, Redbirds. Long pass into the forecourt. Yoder's got it, puts it to the glass, no good. Gets his own missed shot. Back to Bernarding. He'll drive baseline, left layup, no good. Rebounded and clobbered is Greenlee as he goes to the deck. 2:06 to go, third quarter, 43-20. Colton Greenlee, 4 points in the ball game, 2 of 3 from the stripe. Good.
Saegertown's first foul here in the second half. We got some new jerseys coming in here now.
Colton, a 45% foul shooting. Free throw is, spins it in and out. Saegertown quickly up the court, they move. Here's a long three on the right wing, and that is no good. And it ends up going out of bounds. Shot taken by Cole Slosher, who had a three in the ball game earlier. Back in the first half. Here comes Zach. Zach looks right, passes right over to Baker. Baker out front. Down to Tyler Farmer, field fire. That is no good. Rebounded. Shouts to the forecourt, to the top of the key, to the high post. Michaels back out front. Slosher over to Seiple. Seiple in on a
nice feed.
Go lay it up, and that is no good. Saegertown rebounded by Cochranton. Greenlee high post right, double team. Ball's tipped, but gotten out front. And then we'll have a foul call. No timeout. Timeout by the Cards. 1:14 to go, third quarter. Cochranton in control tonight, 44-20 over Saegertown. Back with more on Cool and Armstrong after this timeout.
Welcome back to Action Right Here. Cochranton High School, Truck Stop Big Gear bringing the action. It has been all Cochranton in this game, leading right now 44-20. Minute 14 remaining here in the third period. Cochranton with the ball.
Looking to inbound, finally gets the ball to Baker. He is open, takes up the jumper from 15 and connects.
46-20. Long pass.
Baker with five in the contest. And we're going to get a block foul called against Greenlee. It's cutting down the baseline was Slosher. Seven fouls against Saegertown in this third quarter alone. Cochranton has just one.
And Bernardine back in.
Greenlee goes out.
1:03 remaining here in the third.
Free throw is up and good.
Nothing but net on that one. Nice shot right there. 46-21.
Slosher. Cool now with 4 points and 1-for-1 from the line. Try to make it 2-for-2 and does.
Couple of nice shots.
And Bernarding will bring the ball up. Under a minute to go, third quarter. Frymer, Curtis, down to the baseline to Frymer. Frymer, Seiple on him, push the ball out to the top of the key. 45 seconds to go, third quarter. Cardinals are up 46-22. Hoffman, back to top of the key, over to Bernarding. Over the head pass, back to Hoffman. Farmer, Baker, top of the key, Wigdon, Bernarding. Cardinals now just more or less in a weave out front. Now they get the ball to Zach into the lane, lays it up and in off the glass.
Easy two, 48-22.
6 seconds to go in the period. The ball out front. Here's a deep three, Seiple, and that comes up well short at the end of the third quarter. Fourth quarter is next on Cool and Armstrong with your score. The Cardinals 48, the Panthers 22. Well, it's time for the fourth quarter on Cool 101.7 and Armstrong. Jeff Corey on the camera here, and they'll be playing that back next week. I think the next one will be rolling on the 23 channel will be at 8 o'clock on Wednesday, right, Big Gear?
That's correct. Again, Thursday at 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
All right, there you have a chance to watch the play-by. Here we have Baker out front, high post. Back over to Wigdon, out front to Baker. Baker out front to Zach. To Hoffman. Hoffman looking left, looking right, passes right, down to the right corner to Wigdon. Back out front again. Cardinals got this under control, and they're just
eating up the clock.
Yep. Hoffman out front to Bernarding. Bernarding's going to go in, hook pass out.
Right over
Hoffman, three corner left short. Rebound, Seiple. He is tied up by Brayton, but a foul's going to be called. Brayden with the foul.
Well, that'd be number 8. His third.
At the free throw line, it will be Seiple. I think I said earlier that Cochran only had the one foul. It was the Panthers. Seiple to the strike. Seiple, 60% foul shooter.
Nice shot there.
Hit the line for one more. This cherry toss is short. Down into the hands of Brayton. Up the court to Bernardin. Back out front to Baker. Dish the ball over to Freimuth. Top of the key. Back over to Baker to the left baseline. Back out to Wigdon. Hook pass over here to Freimuth. And then try to get the ball down low to Bernardin. But it's off his fingertips and out of bounds. And three players in for Saegertown. Three, of course, are going out. Rhodes in for Saegertown.
Also, Austin Brown, number 5, checking in. Also 10, that's Grant.
Here they come into the forecourt to
Grant
Phelan. Phelan, jumper good from 10 on the right wing.
There's Grant right there to hit a bucket. 48-25.
Here we go on the other end of the court. Flip it up, it's no good by the Cardinals. Altman ends up going out of bounds.
So Grant's going to throw it in for Saegertown.
48-25 Cards. Led at the end of one. 13-5 and at the half, we're up 32-12. On a 19.
Boy, they're pressing all over Grant. And he turns
steal
it over.
And then what?
And then traveling. So it goes right back to the Panthers. Referee Bill down there saying it's Saegertown's ball.
Bill Kuntz.
With D'Angelo down there refereeing.
And the other one is Tom Gage, who played his basketball high school at Cambridge Springs. Ball is knocked loose, picked up Bernarding. Bernarding all the way up court, dumps the ball to the baseline. Bernarding's got it now. Bernarding out front. To Baker. Push the ball top of the key, around the horn to Bernarding. Back out front. Freimuth, Curtis looks right, passes left. To Wigdon. Bernarding straight out, directs traffic. Over to Baker. Down to the baseline, introduced, trying to force it up, with a foul to be called against Saegertown as Baker is going to lay it up and in, foul on Rhodes.
His first, team's second. 5:41 remaining in this game. Two shots coming up for Cochranton.
And it will be Baker at the free throw line. 66% foul shooter. He is 1-for-1 from the free throw line tonight. Charity toss to the rim. Hit the line for one more. Good.
Splits the pair. 49-25.
Here come the Panthers. Out front, Rhodes. Corner right, Cole Swasher back out front, moving around the perimeter. They had trouble all night getting the ball inside.
Well, they got Austin Brown
Swasher
down there.
Phelan.
He's 6'2", if they could feed it to him.
To Rhodes. Back out front. Here's another long three, and that one is no good. Swasher in underneath the tie-up. Baker and Rhodes. And that possession, as the ball rolls out of bounds, out the door, out into the lobby.
So Grant goes out, let's see, 13 checks in.
Sherrod inbound for Saegertown. He's the one throws the ball away, right into Brown, rolls out of bounds.
Couldn't hold on or didn't see it coming, one of the two. Nevertheless, another turnover for Saegertown.
And directly below us. Freimuth into Bernarding. Bounce the ball left side of Wigdon. Top of the key. Now down to the baseline where Wigdon is open momentarily but passes the ball off. Baker shoots and scores just inside the paint there. Left side from about 13. Baker now with a total of 8 points in the contest. Rhodes out front. High post. Open. Slosher again. Tries a three. No good. Rebounded by Wigdon. 4:20 to go in the game. Wigdon almost lost it. Brings the ball ahead. Hook pass down low. Bernarding an easy two.
Wide open underneath. 53-25.
Slosher. Down low to Sherry. He tried to pass it on and tipped out of bounds by Zach Wigdon. And the starters going out now. That'll be it for the night for them.
Exactly halfway through the fourth period. 53-25 all Cochran. Saegertown with the ball. Here we go.
And here's a long three, and that is no good by Sherry. Rebounded by Cochranton. McKay is now in there for the Redbirds. Also in there is Tyler Freimuth. Garrett Yoder, hook pass down low. Hoffman puts it up. That's no good.
That's
rebounded by Greenlee. He puts it up. It's no good, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Cochranton. 3:35 to go. Back in for Saegertown, Jake Steiger.
Junior, he'll be throwing it in.
Into Pritchard. 2-3 zone cards. Corner to Slosher. Rhodes. Hunt to Pritchard. Slosher. Dump the ball down low in underneath. And double dribble is going to be called against Austin Brown. Sam Michaels, 6 foot senior, in for the Cats. Going out, Slosher. Point lead for the Cards. Tyler Freimuth out front, and the ball's lost into the backcourt. Cochran touching it, the Panthers touch it, and the Cochran steals it. Yoder up the court, Greenlee, he'll go in, lay it up and in, and a pushing off on. Basket is good. Greenlee, who didn't start the ball game, is now a total of 4 points in the ball game, and he is hit 3 of 5 from the free throw line. That one won't go. And a rebound, Panthers.
Foul was on Austin Brown, his first for Saegertown.
45 to go on this one here.
Saegertown's third team foul.
Cardinals man-to-man. Rhodes out front. Rhodes dumps the ball down to Pritchard. Pritchard will try one left corner, no good, but rebound laid up and in with the left hand by Rhodes.
Good second effort, up and in, 55-27. Cochran cruising to a win tonight.
Been on a cruise all night long.
Yeah, they have. Make it 57-27.
Greenlee goes in for two.
2:15 running in this game. It'll be over.
Rhodes out front, left wing. Top of the key, Pritchard. Pritchard down to the
Brown.
Baseline for Brown.
Austin Brown, it's a three. The big guy delivers. First one in the second half for Saegertown.
Here driving into Greenlee, another two on the other end of the court.
Make it 59-30.
Greenlee, six in the period. Michaels. And a timeout called by Saegertown.
Look that way.
We'll take a timeout on Cool, 30-second timeout. 59-30. Panthers trail the Cardinals on Cool and Armstrong tonight. 137, and this one will be all over tonight from Cardinal Land. Cardinals have had their way tonight in this one here.
Just checking in, be number 22 for Saegertown. Adams, 5'11 senior.
Panthers have the ball. Dijon inbounds. Top of the key over to Michaels. He's going to dribble to a free throw.
Turn around, big guy.
Shot to the rim, no good. Rebounded by the Cardinals. Ball down. Out front, quickly around the point. Now in underneath for the driving layup, up on the rim. And that is no good by Suter of the Cardinals.
Drew the foul, Saegertown's fourth team foul. Minute 16 remaining. Two shots coming up for Cochranton.
At the free throw line will be Miller. His first trip to the line tonight. Sophomore, 6'5", shoots, scores.
60-30. One more shot coming up.
Few dribbles. Sights the hole and puts her home.
61-30. Wow, Cochranton.
And the Panthers move into the forecourt, and the ball is just thrown away. 69 seconds to go. We'll talk to you from Cambridge Springs with Cochranton on a Tuesday night. Cards of the forecourt down to the baseline, going in. Suter puts it up and in, but they'll call it off.
What do you call
a charge, I think.
Looks that way. Yep, caught him on the charge.
Saegertown's basketball.
101 remaining on the clock. Adams throwing it in.
And bringing the ball up the court will be Steiger. Steps inside the three-point arc, right of the circle, to Dijon. Dijon dribbles to the top of the key.
What
and
the
just throws
heck was
it
that?
Up.
Just about no made idea. It. Now, yeah. Oh, Michaels with the rebound.
He gets fouled.
I don't know if he was going to pass it or if he tried a hook shot or something.
He's talking with the coach now. Both have big smiles.
Boy,
down here.
He just about hit it, though.
Big smile he's got. Coach Molnar telling him to stay back.
Michaels at the foul line. Comes up a little short on the first shot. 10 fouls against Cochranton. See if Michaels can hit this one.
It is up and it is no good. Strong again.
Nope, 0 for 2.
Cardinals have it. Try to run this clock out. In underneath, Suter's got it. Throws up at the side of the backboard. It's no good. Rebounded by Saegertown's Adams.
Trying to hold on to it.
Adams fell down. The ball ran out of bounds.
Little fancy footwork. Couldn't quite hold on to it. Dancing with the Stars. Here we go, back to action.
I thought that was on TV.
Could have sworn we just saw it.
Now into the corner, back out front with 20 seconds to go in the ball game. Baseline, out front. The Cardinals, now down to the
there
baseline.
There it goes, look at that.
Short jumpers.
Oh.
That is no good. And a foul called number 5 with the ball, and I don't have a 5 on the roster. Must have been brought off the JV team.
Freshman, middle school, 8 seconds remain, 61-30.
Free throw line, shot is up and no good. One more shot coming up for number 5. It is good.
Austin Brown throws it in.
With 6 seconds to go.
Oh!
Right into the Cardinal bench goes Suter for the Cards.
Boy, good hustle there.
He's okay. Jumps right up and back out onto the court.
Sam Michaels throws it into Adams.
Adams
what's that?
30-footer. It's no good. That's the end of the ball game. Final score tonight. It is the Cochranton Cardinals 62, Saegertown 30. We'll be back and wrap this one up on Armstrong. Want to thank our viewers on Armstrong tonight, watching our game here between Cochranton and Saegertown. But the Cochranton Cardinals, too much for Saegertown. They roll to the victory, 62-30. That'll do it for our folks on Armstrong. Thank you for joining us.